be obedient to the commands that God has given us. The principles of God's laws do not change. And throughout the ages, God continues to require both faith and obedience from His followers. By remembering the teachings they have received, and as we remember the teachings we have received, then we will not be prone, we will not be given to falling for false doctrine. And so in verse 9 of Hebrews chapter 13, be not carried away, be not carried about with divers and strange doctrines. For it is a good thing that the heart be established with grace, not with means, which have not profited them that have been occupied therein. From the 9th verse of this chapter, the writer warns of the possibility of Christians following many different and new unheard of doctrines. The Jews would follow some of the old doctrines that were proclaimed under the Mosaic Law. And we know there are different false doctrines that are set forth in the New Testament that Paul had to deal with, for example, in 1 Timothy 1, 18 and 19. In 2 Timothy chapter 2, verses 17 and 18. And some of those same doctrines are being proclaimed in the 21st century. And in the 21st century, brethren are being drawn away after false doctrine. And one of the reasons they're being drawn away from the truth, the false doctrines, is because they have not remained in the gospel. They have not continued to study and to learn God's word. The recipients of the book of Hebrews had problems with spiritual growth, just as we studied yesterday from Hebrews chapter 5, verses 12 through 14. For when for the time ye ought to be teachers, ye had need that one teach you again, which be the first principles of the oracles of God, and become such as had need of milk and not of strong meat. For everyone that useth milk is unskillful in the word righteousness, for he is a babe. But strong meat belongeth to them that are of full age, even those who by reason of use have their senses exercised to discern both good and evil. Paul also warns of the dangers of being unstable doctrinally. Ephesians 4, verse 14. That we henceforth be no more children, tossed to and fro, and carried about with every wind of doctrine, by the sleight of men and cunning craftiness, whereby they lie in wait to deceive. Peter added in 2 Peter 3, 15 through 18. And account that the long-suffering of our Lord is salvation, even as our beloved brother Paul, also according to the wisdom given unto him, hath written unto you, as also in all his epistles, speaking in them of these things, in which are some things hard to be understood, which they that are unlearned and unstable rest, that is to twist or to torture, as they also do the other scriptures, unto their own destruction. Ye therefore, beloved, seeing you know these things before, beware lest ye also, being led away with the error of the wicked, fall from your own steadfastness, but grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. To him be glory both now and forever. The book of Hebrews also deals with the problem of Christians returning to the practice of Judaism instead of continuing in the better covenant. That is why the writer emphasizes the heart being established with grace instead of food to no profit. We don't have time to talk about what the writer says here in Hebrews 13, 9 through 14. But he's talking about the importance of our worship and our future home. This morning we talked about in Hebrews 10 of the importance of worship. the importance of assembling with the saints so that we can continue to grow and have the benefits of fellowship in Christ. And there are several reminders in this, the last sections of this chapter. Because we are in Christ and enjoy the privileges of worship and spiritual blessings, we should continually give praise and thanks. We should also remember to do good and to help those in need. We are reminded to look out for our souls to be sure that they give a good report of our service in the church. What a great prayer to pray for gospel preachers. They will have a good conscience in all of the work of the church and not be tempted by the devil to not live honestly. The book of Hebrews is devoted to proving Jesus Christ is worthy of faith. It is also written to show Christianity is superior to Judaism. It is through the shed blood of Christ that we have the opportunity to be saved. It is also by His resurrection from the dead that we have the hope of eternity. It was the hope of the writer to encourage the brethren to continue to obey the gospel and not go back into Judaism. It was his hope. The things discussed in this chapter and the entire book would help them to do just that. May the book of Hebrews also help us to see the only road to heaven is through Christ and His Word. John 12:48, he that rejecteth me and receiveth not my word hath one that judgeth him. The word that I have spoken, the same shall judge him in the last day. If we are not in Christ, we do not have access to the spiritual blessings that are found in Christ. If we are not in Christ, we are outside of Christ and therefore have no hope and do not have God in this world. I was not able to ever hear Brother W. E. Bradfield preach a gospel sermon. I think Lydia probably did. I never had that opportunity. But I was told that when he conducted gospel meetings wherever he went, that when the invitation song would be sung, as they were singing the invitation song, Brother Bradfield would be walking down along the front of the pews, and he would point at people. I'm going to be careful not to point anybody here. But he would actually point at people, and he would say, "No hope! No hope!" If we're outside of Christ, we have no hope. To get into Christ, we must obey the gospel. Hearing the gospel, believing it with all of our heart, repenting of our every sin, confessing our faith in Christ, we can then be immersed in water so that the precious blood of Christ can wash away our sins. And then we rise to walk in newness of life. We begin living the Christian life, putting the Lord first in our lives, living one day at a time, living faithfully until the Lord returns, so that we can hear the words of our Lord on that day of judgment. Well done, thou good and faithful servant. Enter thou in into the joys of thy Lord. If you're not a Christian today, you have an opportunity to become a child of God. Or maybe you're a member of the Lord's church and you've not been given a wholehearted effort in living the Christian life. You've not been serving God as you should. Why not come back today, make those things right with your brethren and with God, and determine that from today onward, all of us are going to live for God so that we can have the hope of eternal life. We've selected a song to encourage you and to give you an opportunity. We urge you to come together. We stand with you.